Hello everyone, Narcissist Free Almost here, and today I wanted to talk about how narcissists use cognitive bias against their targets. And we know that they do rely heavily on certain psychological mechanisms to manipulate their audience and their targets. Most of us know they rely on the halo effect, which is leaving someone with a positive first impression, which in and of itself is not a bad thing. Everyone hopes to do that. But for the narcissist, it becomes a deliberate move to leave you feeling good about them and yourself with the intention of building trust to use against you at a later date. But what about the smear campaign? That is, once the narcissist has smeared you to everyone, why do people seem to believe them? What other psychological mechanism does the narcissist exploit in others? And like I mentioned in the beginning, it's called cognitive bias, which is a systematic thought process caused by the tendency of the human brain to simplify information processing through a filter of personal experience and preferences. Which makes sense, especially these days where humans are inundated with vast amounts of information to process. But even more specific than that is confirmation bias, where people have the tendency to favor information that confirms or strengthens their beliefs or values and is difficult to dislodge once in place. So let me get into this a little bit more and you'll see why people often buy the smear campaign. Now, what causes confirmation bias? As it turns out, it's there to protect self-esteem. People like to feel good about themselves, and discovering that a belief they highly value is incorrect makes them feel bad about themselves. Therefore, people will seek out information that supports their existing beliefs. In other words, people like to be right. Interestingly enough, confirmation bias reinforces stereotypes, and once formed, people tend to seek out information that supports their preconceived notions and categories instead of allowing contradictory information to dissolve those formed ideas. An example of confirmation bias in the workplace would be that a coworker is lazy. So if someone is singled out as a lazy person, you tend to view everything they do as slow and lazy. Why is confirmation bias so powerful? Because this bias impacts how we gather information, but also influences how we interpret and recall information. Confirmation bias relates to how we perceive and judge evidence. Of course, the narcissist will exploit each and every one of the types of cognitive bias by planting seeds in advance and going for the victim's jugular. For example, the narcissist will go for the easiest trigger and/or bias by spreading lies about you. These will more than likely be projections, that is, something they're doing to you, like cheating on you, but tell everyone that you are cheating on them. Cheating is a huge emotional trigger for most people, and why would you lie about something like that, right? That's a pretty serious accusation. But what most people don't know is that the pathological narcissist will do anything for attention, and most of them are compulsive liars. So once this genie is out of the bottle, the ambient abuse for the target begins, because typically the target won't even know anything about this rumor, and people with their cognitive biases will be highly judgmental towards the target, distant, or even angry, confusing the target terribly. And the narcissist is sadistically enjoying every bit of this drama, I promise you. It is here I've noticed three types of reactions from people. The first one is from people who love you and truly care about you, and they may dance around the subject if they bring it up at all, but don't change towards you. In fact, there may be a feeling of sympathy, like they feel bad for you for some reason. The second group will be people who are confused and unsure. They will be curiously observing the target while keeping some distance. They are good people who either don't know what to believe or don't want to get involved because they have proper boundaries and a healthy sense of skepticism. They are the going to wait and see group. The third group are your toxic ones who buy it hook, line, and sinker and can't wait to sink their teeth into this one. They will be angry on behalf of the narcissist, which is just the way the narc likes it. Here, the narcissist has the potential to build his or her army of flying monkeys. This perceived transgression against the narcissist is unforgivable and profoundly egregious in their minds. These are the dangerous ones who will act on the narcissist's behalf, and this makes the narc feel powerful. Not to mention getting other people to do his or her dirty work. They can keep their hands clean. The bottom line for this group is that they are likely narcissists themselves, but at the very least, highly, highly toxic. In these three groups, there are certain levels of biases going on. The first, and especially the second group, have pretty healthy boundaries and perhaps only a mild level of bias going on. But the third, well, these are the ones the narcissist wants the most. They will be blind to looking at situations objectively, which will negatively influence their decisions, leading to poor and faulty choices, of course, against the target. Regardless, narc is going to get the most for his or her money and knows that telling someone their spouse is having an affair definitely does just that. The narcissist gets his or her desperately needed supply to puff themselves up while turning people against the spouse and then getting people on their team as well. This particular little gem is also used when the narc is getting ready to dump their target. But wouldn't the narcissist's audience be angry about being lied to? Well, since the narcissist doesn't care about anyone, they don't care how you feel about anything, and they go on their merry way. They might deny they said it like you remember it, or just plain old behave as if nothing was said at all, bewildering their audience members. Remember, one of their best tricks is pretending like something never happened at all. They despise accountability and having to explain themselves. That's so beneath them. Sadly, the damage is done, with the narcissist having exploited people's own biases against them. In many cases, the target doesn't even know any of this is going on, because the narcissist is doing it behind their back, of course, and never once brings it up to the target. The shock value is priceless to a sadistic narcissist, and they will revel in everyone's reactions, and especially watch the target's confusion, hurt, and upset. Here they get double the supply with no one the wiser, and watching everyone gossip, reeling from the dirty secrets, and usually all fiction of course, is especially delicious. I can't emphasize enough how these people are dangerous to your credibility and reputation at the very least, and all for attention, or for winning, or for revenge, or sometimes just because they're bored. They don't care who they hurt as long as they get to regulate themselves, feel better, and get what they want when they want it. So I want you to picture this so you can appreciate what's going on in the narcissist's mind when they're smearing you. Imagine a spoiled, rotten 10-year-old all snuggled up in the corner of his bedroom, giggling and excited from running all the way home after starting a neighbor's house on fire. They're watching all the adults spinning, worried and frightened as the fire truck speeds past the house. How powerful the evil child feels, being able to manipulate all of these adults. He's so much smarter than they are in this moment, and he's getting back at them for whatever. Even more delicious is that this secret will be kept in his memory to feed off every time he wants to feel smart and powerful. And an even better secret is that no one will ever figure out that he never feels bad about it, and he loves feeling this way. So it would behoove you to adhere to the old adage, when it comes to narcissists, believe nothing you hear and only half of what you see.